have what's called a starter. And if possible, we can see if we can try to actually run one. So what is the starter? The starter kit is really kind of like a complete PWA scaffolded app that has already been set up with a service worker, places for manifest, simple routes, uses Lit, which is lightweight web components, and is, we'll kind of do one if we have time and, you know, depending on what you want to do. We'll try to actually use it and run it through their own report card. It'll have a really high score. It's very light. I think it's almost 100 lighthouse score as well. So in a sense, you're getting out of the box a fully featured route-friendly PWA that you can then start scaffolding out. And if you're interested in what that looks like, I actually am working on seeing what it takes to deploy these to GitHub. This is my version of what that looks like. I had to tweak the colors a little bit because the default colors couldn't be read. But you can see that it really just has a very simple kind of routes, tells you what it's using. Here is my kicker. PWA Builder, currently all the samples and all are using TypeScript. That means I need to skill myself up on TypeScript. But
I have a course for that.
Please, we need to do this. What I did find is looking at the source, it's really, and I think maybe Christopher, you will agree on this, TypeScript is actually very easy to read and understand. It's like kind of like figuring out what's happening where. So this is the stack they use under the covers. If you want to get started with a PWA, and just for the heck of it, since this comes from the starter, if we have time, I'll kind of show you how that's actually run.
Yeah.
But I'll show you what the score of this is. So this is the one I've deployed right to my GitHub endpoint. So if we actually look at this, you'll see that its score is super high. So it kind of comes out of the box compliant. And all you need to do is add in your code for the different routes and like then keep testing and so on. So PWA starter kit, that's my first tip. Like, go check that out. And then, let me see. There's one other thing I want to talk about. So one of the reasons that I had actually looked at this, so it's in here. One of the reasons I looked at this, and I put them in the links at the bottom of my favorites tab, is with PWA Builder, there's a whole bunch of example apps. There are articles with example apps that I think that really kind of drew me to, hey, we can use this and try to build something on it. I want to point one of them out because it did come from Google. I'm a Surface Duo fan, so I got to say this. I thought this was pretty cool. There are dual screen APIs that through media queries, you can kind of create dual screen behaviors. So with PWA Builder, there was a blog post shared on the Surface Duo blog just a couple of months ago that walks you through an example of an app that you can use starting with PWA Builder, a progressive web app that is also kind of configured to use the dual screen media queries and kind of build a experience that is optimal for those kinds of devices. So definitely check this article out. And if you're interested in it, they also have two other things. This one I'm a little bit, why not? So what was worrying me about this is look at the date on this. I'm like, was it supposed to have been published and they didn't know? Like, do you see what I mean? We are living in the future right here. But anyway.
I mean, at this point, what is time? It could very well be July 15th today for all I know. I mean,
hey, we are all variants. This is all I'm hearing from my kid. We are all variants. All right, great. Okay. But what I will love about this is like, you know, with PWA started, they're using components, right? So they actually have a PWA inking component that you can use to do 2D drawing. And this is, you know, a little passion of mine. So one of the reasons I like this starter kit is the samples they have. They have a drawing app, an inking app, and a dual screen app. So definitely go check those out that I can think of. I was actually going to show you how to just quickly run a PWA starter, but maybe we don't have time for that.
If it'll take like 2 minutes, you've got 2 minutes.
Oh, all right. So we can do it very, very simply. So there are two ways to do it. One is you can just go into this and am I logged in? So if you go into the PWA builder, the easiest way to do it is you just go into PWA starter. It's a template. So you can literally use this template, it'll fork it and give you that entire kind of code base and then all you have to do it. So I've actually created a version of it. I've installed it. I mean, I've downloaded it from a zip file. So I'm going to just unzip that. And all you have to do, it's as simple as this. So if you kind of look at this, there are just two steps. Once you've downloaded this code, and I, by the way, Craft Toolkit, you got to look at it. So you go into this and so you just have to do npm install npm run dev. So if I had them do for dependencies. So once we have the dependencies met, if you do a run dev, it'll actually launch it locally.
Are you on the, carry on. Ignore me.
Yet? It's over there.
Yep.
Okay, so they're done. So now if you do npm run dev, I want to just show this to you because you'll see that the version that comes up. So do you see it just launched it there? Takes a minute, but this, do you see how the font colors are terrible? This is why changed that a little bit. But that's it. It's as simple as that. And right now, when you've kind of got this running, it has service workers installed. Anytime you want to figure out what's the PWA support in yours, you can go in here, look at service workers are running. You can see that it's basically activated and running. Manifest exists. There's even, I think, screenshots does not specify its size. Okay, so there are certain things that need to be fixed. But anyway, it's as simple as that. So you've got yourself a running PWA scaffold, and now you can go in and kind of start working on your actual routes and component-based pages.